Hello guys. My name is Jalen Coleman. And this isn't a joke I'm gonna play. This is the most serious game that I will ever play. I don't know if this game is real. I don't know if it's fake. I don't know. But I know one thing. It's about cancer. And cancer is a serious problem that these people, the people like me and you, have to deal with. So hopefully, I'm not gonna make any jokes about cancer or anything. I'm gonna play through this serious. Because it might be real. Okay. I might even cry if it's that, if it's the saddest people say it is.
Don't touch the birds. No, they're gross. Yeah. Okay.
It's kind of emotional now. The sound effects are bad. I don't even know if this game is based on real events. I really hope this
guys, could kill somebody. Mom,
you
threw the whole piece.
Well, Isaac, you gotta give him little pieces. He doesn't understand. Okay, no, you throw.
Your level's 5, right?
Yeah.
but he can't talk.
It's true.
Yeah.
We always can talk.
Yeah, I know.
Why can't Joel?
Well, Joel got sick right after he turned 1. And,
kind of slowed him down a little bit, buddy.
Yeah. So he's just slower than most kids.
Let's turn on this sensitivity. Sensitivity is pretty high.
Eventually he'll catch up.
What? You think Joel will read?
There's more bread though,
but. Yeah, I think Joel will read eventually.
Well, Isaac, of course. It's just the way. Because, you know.
Yeah.
He's supposed to be a boy, but he's a baby. He's a boy.
Yep, he's a boy baby. That's just about right. You know, there's lots of things Joel isn't good at, but there's some things he is good at. What is he good at?
Eating, laughing.
Yeah.
What is it making him laugh?
You are good at making them laugh. Why, how do you make them laugh?
I fall down.
Yeah. It's really funny when you fall down.
He's good at showing us what he loves.
Yeah. Want some more? know why it's making that weird clicking noise. I don't think I'm supposed to be playing this with a PS4 controller, so I'm gonna put the PS4 controller down and I use mouse and keyboard. Sorry.
What does Joel love? Wawa. In cups, bathtubs, and the warm, wet tongues and the cool fur of Das. Maybe the sweet moas of daily affection. And bye-byes. And blowy kisses. And more. Ugh. Always more. This full list of words. So few.
It wasn't that low for the PS4 controller. This really looks happy. Sensitivity for this game is really low, isn't it?
What is pain without a word for it? What is hope without a word for it? Who is God? What is joy?
I'm making me contemplate a lot of things.
Who am I to him?
Here's that.
Dada.
Apparently,
it's
tilted.
Give
me
a kiss.
Ready?
Yeah. Me and Zoe kiss.
Yeah. Go.
You say hi, Zoe.
Having fun?
Hi, Zoe.
Now give Joe a kiss.
Do it again. Do it again.
Okay, Joel. Ready? Set.
He's giving Joel a kiss.
Go.
Do a kiss.
Let's go, little buddy. Yeah. Fast on that slide now, aren't you?
Can you give Zoe a kiss?
So they're taking care of him, and that's how he gets his food. His food goes through that too.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Set.
Yeah. You want to touch him?
Go.
Yeah. Woo. Why don't you just pat his cheek, okay?
Of course.
Okay.
Alright, buddy.
Pat his cheek. Yes. Oh. See? It's Jolly.
Okay, Joel. Ready?
Go.
Set.
Go.
You want to touch him, Kayla?
Oh, no.
Ready?
No. Okay. You can just pat his head over here if you want. What do you think, Isaac? He's in the hospital, so they're taking care of him. And that's how he gets his food? His food goes through that, too. Yeah. You want to touch him? Yeah?
Yeah, buddy.
Fear is cancer's preservative, cancer's embalming oil. And you, O accuser, are fear's oil salesman. You're a snake, a serpent, a dragon with snuffed out coal on his breath, molting, talons broken from the struggle to free yourself of your own skin.
Actually kind of emotional. So So I don't think the kid died, but like, I guess, I don't know, he was, the way he's recovering him, so we're finding out. So like, it might be like symbolic for like the way it's overcame him, the way it represented cancer. He might not have made it. And that's actually kind of sad. I'm not gonna lie, I'm starting to get kind of emotional here. On the hospital time. I hate the little hospitals. There's just something about it makes you feel like you're trapped.
Hey, do you want a rock? Okay, let's rock. There we go. Oh,
hey babe, I was just thinking, do you ever think maybe Joel can hear better than he's supposed to be able to? Because I know, like, it's supposed to be moderate to severe hearing loss, but sometimes, like today, he hears music playing before I do. So I saw him dancing, and I had to look around to hear that a song was playing. And I just don't, like, if his hearing loss is that bad, I can't imagine. I don't know. I just wonder about it. Anyway, call me later. Bye.
What's going on? Oh, crap. Fix it, Joel. I think that's what his name was. What's going on? Is that what he's being fed with? Can you imagine how terrible that must be? I've read there's always just to be there for me when we have hospital. We get scared, or someone gets scared. You know, at least come out of here and make balloons out of them. Could you imagine, though, having to spend the last moments of your life in a small room? It's really sad. I wouldn't be able to comprehend how helpless you feel. Supposed to block him. I don't know, the winds were saying to run him. Hey, little buddy. The winds were saying to run into him, so I thought.
Oh, hey. I just wanted to take a shower. Is that okay? Are you okay with Joel? Okay, thanks.
We're someone else right now. Aww, he's got a little service dog. Beautiful. Hello, buddy.
Petey. Yeah. Hi, buddy.
Hello? Just knock on the door. See, I'll serve this dog now. That's adorable. I can't tell which one's cuter, him or the dog. I was gonna sell for both. Just kidding, Joel's cuter. I think his name's Joel. I'm having trouble remembering the names right now. No, I'm just gonna refer to him as a baby until I hear his name again. I'll try to remember it. If you can tell from my blending and pushing a video, I have really bad trouble remembering names. Like, this is really lagging right now. Okay. Oh my god, it feels so bad. Can you imagine how bad it must feel to be that hopeless? Aimlessly walking around the halls. Bernie and Eden. Voicemail from Amy. Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. I'm crying. I'm kind of crying right now.
Hey, honey, we're on our way home from the hospital now. So if you wanted to preheat the oven starting in about 30 minutes, that would work, and we could throw in that lasagna. Do you know how they celebrate off treatment day, like when kids are done with their treatments? I guess maybe you don't because you're not in the clinic as much as I am, but on someone's last day, they always bring them a cake and they sing happy off therapy day to you. Anyway. You that happened today. I mean, it happens a lot, but today I cried. I just wanted that day so bad, you know? I just, like, we're not ever gonna get that day. If he's better, we won't know that he's better. We don't get a day. Anyway, okay, call me if you can. Like, there's probably traffic, so I could talk on my way home. All right, bye.
They might not get that day. They might not. Oh, you're really a little buddy. You're over the top. Oh, Lord. I'm kind of looking at this.
Woo! Oh, buddy!
Let's go. Let's go. These chickens are something to hold us back and not keep it.
Woo!
Yeah, I'm not. I should back to the first.
how long is it going to be before we can have some answers?
It's a lot of medicine.
Did anyone ask the doctor?
Okay, is it just the doctor on call, or is this our doctor? Well, because the on-call doctor is just a resident.
Is there a way we could talk to our doctor? It just seemed like yesterday in clinic they were going to let us go. I just want to know what the plan is. Isn't it dangerous for him not to get it? I thought he needed that.
I know you're just doing this for sake, but can I just talk to the doctor that was...
That one of your kids might not... Oh, okay, I gotta stop crying. Gotta continue on with the game. Okay. I just enjoyed the little golf race again. Good day, boys. See you again later, buddy. Joel. Call the elevator. Okay. I don't know if I'll be able to get through the rest of this without crying even more than I already am. I'm not crying, I'm just it just saddened me, to be honest. Temple man. This looks like one of them rooms where people watch life surgery and stuff. It is. It's one of the rooms where you can watch the stuff as it's happening.
Watch out, saddest.
Okay. Woo! It's adorable.
You touch it right here, then the big lion comes.
Big old lion?
You're a scary lion.
Yeah.
So loud. Ooh, I can roar just like him.
Jenny.
Yeah,
sorry.
Hear me roar.
Yeah.
Roar!
Scary.
Don't be afraid. You might want to cover your ears. Here comes animals. Tyrannosaurus is my favorite.
I bet you want to ride the dog now, don't you? Look at him go. Adorable like it is. Now what in the world could this be? Might be on. The line of it.
This terrible routine, watching you, waiting for you to wake, hoping you will never remember these days of illness and treatment. Yeah. One day, I'll bring you here, show you your tiny handprints on the wall, and you'll be annoyed that we all think of you as some big miracle. Cancer will be such a small part of all you could grow to be. You will tire of hearing about it. You won't want to see the cards and notes I saved. And I won't mind at all. I'll hold the memories of this hard day. You, Joel, just leave it behind.
Joel, you're so adorable, man. Just like every time he's went here? I think it is. Mathers do. Oh no. Are these real people? 1998 to 2008. I'm so all my UIHC kids and families, Gray Grace. Thank you, Gray. To my hero, Henry Yen. Branley Stewart, 1979-1983. He was 4 years old. Miss you always. To everyone who's ever died of cancer, especially my father and grandmother, rest in peace, Hank, Marcia, and all the rest of you beautiful, beautiful people. I hope that whatever's become of you, you are presently better off than you were at the end of your life. We miss you. Elise, we love you dearly and miss you daily. See you soon. This is sad. But have no fear, our story's just begun. Jason Javier Sanchez, 1980-2008. I believe that's 28 years old, forever in our hearts. Love you out of your life, Jason, sir. You're stronger than you know. Love will keep you strong. Have faith like children and love like Christ. Why do it if it's not fun? In memory, Rick Miller. He seems like a nice, good guy. I'd like to meet that guy. If every hour wounds, let us sit a minute. It's a good quote. Another memory of Maria and Emil Hashzowitsky. Love you, Papa. Even now, you still make me laugh. beautiful. I miss you, Rachel. Oh my god. So many people come in here and never come out, and the thought of that. The thought of these poor people who will only be remembered by not a lot. They didn't really have enough time on Earth to leave a legacy. Take my tears, love. They will carry you home. These people, they didn't have enough time. I still love you, girl from Mars. This is actually depressing. We belong to each other. I shall cover you away until I have passed. Not an animal, mundo me importa. Es que yo me hijo, el guanvi.
Sorry, this is in the butt.
These people have lost so. I don't even know if he's a real one.
For my brother Kyle, no.
You went in your sleep after months of pain. Miss you, Grandpa. To me, a loving wife, a mother, my grandmother, and a cancer survivor. Hardly a woman of grace, but a person of great strength. I'm glad you get to continue a fight. Your fight should I ever arise again. I love you, Grandma. Okay. She really don't wait. She is okay. In loving memory of Han and Don. I
Joshua, stay strong, little man. Mommy and daddy love you. The countless hours up. John, I miss you every day. Love me. Nancy, you were an eternally embodied compassion to me. Sonia, Anna, Shadforth, I love you always and forever. Oh my god. These poor people love it so much. I love the Gigi and the friend that saved me. In the dark of night, I wish for you milk and bread, breath and health. To my beloved girl named Leander, these people have put countless hours into fighting this, and at what cost? They don't survive it. Some of them know, and that's the bad thing. I need to stay close to you. You died. Love, Madison. Keep sorrow in your heart for those that die before their time. May you find peace, strength, and rest, Kyle. In loving memory of Santa Monte, Dion, and Carl Peterson, gone but never forgotten. The important thing is not that dragons exist, but that they can breathe, be beaten. Stephanie, Pete, Juana, George, Charlie, loved and missed. I love you, Abraham. You'll always be my inspiration. Brenda Green, lost, never forgotten, and always loved. Departure, Godspeed, bless his heart, good Lord. Klein Nelly, do lips, whiter, and Seren Herzl. Mommy, oh no, their kid, her kid. I guess so. Mommy, we love you and we miss you. Mika is our daddy. Lucky Lou, stay strong and keep fighting. Lucky Lou. Let's hope he was lucky. You'll always be in my heart for my father, Frederick William Meyer. And my little brother, Dimitri, in the cancer he fought. I can't, man. This game's got me. I can't do that. Until you find freedom in eternal sleep at your past, and the angels shall weep. All our hearts shall cry with despair,
We hope you rest in peace, Claire. I have never cried at a game before. This is the first time that a game has actually made me cry. For Scott and the world we never built. The father cried out, I believe. Oh my unbelief. I'm sorry guys, if you don't like to listen to my crying, it's just... These are sad. Chloe and Benji are special ones, love mom and daddy. I don't think I can read anymore. I'm gonna read like one more. Hey, Jade and Carlo, Craftsman and father. I'm sorry to the one, if these are real people, I'm sorry, but I can't read another one. I can't, it's that bad. I can't. Sorry, those who's. I'm sorry. God, that was depressing. I'm sorry, guys. It's not good.
What?
You wanna play? You wanna play? What about the piggy? What's the piggy say? What's the pig say, everybody?
Farmer Bill makes the pigs bacon for breakfast.
Again.
Farmer Bill plays fetch with the pigs.
Farmer Bill.
Farmer Bill enjoys a mud bath with the pigs.
Farmer Bill's crazy, isn't he? Yeah? Okay.
Farmer Bill scratches the pig's chinny chin chin.
I bet the pig's little bad. No, 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 buddy. Do it again.
Farmer Bill gives the pigs piggyback rides.
That's silly. Is it Farmer Bill?
Some mischievous pigs are napping on Farmer Bill's couch.
I would, to be honest.
The pigs wash the dishes after supper.
They're silly.
Farmer Bill separates the sheep from the goats. Sheep go to heaven. Goats go to town.
I'm sorry, guys. It's not good. I'm sorry, guys. It's not good. I'm sorry, guys. It's not good.
No. Please don't tell me.
I'm sorry, guys. It's not good.
No.
I'm sorry, guys. It's not good.
No. Size matters. If I know how big it is, I can face it. I can size it up.
And it's quite small at this point, but unfortunately the size isn't terribly important. Any recurrence means the chemotherapy has failed.
No.
This is a tragedy.
No.
I guess I have imagined it.
With an ATR team,
I've imagined it a lot, but not like this.
It is fatal.
It's different. I thought I would sob uncontrollably or puke just right on the floor. I thought I'd shake or wail or something.
We can't continue to give him chemotherapy.
I guess guess this is shock. Tragedy, he said. That's right. That's the perfect word for this.
Bye.
It's a tragedy. I wonder if he says that every time. He's crying a little. I love him for that. He's not callous. He's genuinely sad. She is too.
So there just aren't any treatment options that are curative.
I'm afraid to press this button. Can I just go back? I'm afraid to press the button.
With an ATRT, as soon as you have a recurrence of any kind, it is fatal.
No.
It's only a matter of time before it spreads to several locations. We've already thrown all the chemotherapy we have at it. We can't continue to give him chemotherapy that we know it's resistant to. So there just aren't any treatment options that are curative.
Oh my God, can you imagine being in that position? Can you imagine being that father?
We're very good at end-of-life care. We're very good at managing the pain and masking symptoms at the end of life. We're very good at managing the pain and masking symptoms at the end of life.
No, I don't want to look at the video.
How long are we talking about?
A few weeks to maybe 4 months.
The radiation would buy us some time.
No, nothing will really buy us any time at this point. It just can make the time you have left more comfortable. So, we'll schedule you to come back in Monday, and we'll have some options for you to consider. We're so sorry.
Thank you.
How do you do this?
We can do this because it is an honor to know Joel. And to know you. To treat him and to be here. Thank you. That means a lot.
You're welcome.
I'm sorry, guys. It's not good.
Yama?
They've always been clear. Joel's got a recurrence of a tumor. Where is it? How big is it? Well, it's in the frontal cortex. And it's quite small at this point. But unfortunately, the size isn't terribly important. Any recurrence means the chemotherapy is failed. This is a tragedy. With an ATRT, as soon as you have a recurrence of some kind, it's only a matter of time before it spreads in several locations. We've already thrown all the chemotherapy we have at it. We can't continue to give him chemotherapy that we know it's resistant to. So there just aren't any options for the cure.
We're very good at the end of life care. We're very good at managing pain and masking symptoms at the end of life. How long are we talking about?
Adrenaline? what you do. What the person to do when they get when they're told that their kid is only a few weeks or a few months old? What is someone to do?
Things stirring around in my spirit that I have to write. I have to write to settle myself and find God's wisdom in the midst of chaos. I'm scared I won't be strong enough to face the things we might have to face in the coming weeks and months. But then I remember how much grace God gave us to walk out everything we've already faced. I've never felt completely overwhelmed, and I've never felt alone. So no matter what comes next, and I truly cannot even begin to guess how this will go, I know we will be carried. I want to shout out, look what God is about to do, watch how he delivers Joel. And at the same time, I want to roll up in a silent ball and wait it out with fear and trembling, so aware of all my doubt, but yet convinced that my doubt is insignificant compared to God's faithfulness.
Dear Eli, I feel nothing but pride for the way you battled cancer. I remember the way you learned to ride your tricycle down the hospital hallway instead of down the sidewalk like other three-year-olds. It was hard for me to pray to God, "Thy will be done," when I really just wanted so desperately for him to heal you. In the 4.5 years that you dealt with harsh treatments, only once did you ask why God let you get cancer. I hope he has been able to explain the why to you, as I have always believed that he knew how strong you were and wanted to use you in your situation to positively impact so many lives. I remember how you never let me go to bed without telling me that you loved me, and how those were your very last words to me. You taught me what was truly important in life, son.
No.
Still now, years after you left Earth, people are impacted by your life and the lessons you taught us. Thousands of people from around the world read your blog and still feel such a strong connection to you, even though they never met you in person.
His last words to his dad were, "I love you. How dirty you are, that's sad."
We've been through so much already. This is a new degree of tragedy, but it's not so much different from the struggle we've all.
I remember the day I was diagnosed. I remember the hallucinations from the high fever, a 5-year-old's nightmares. I remember my mother silently weeping in the doctor's office. I remember friends and family gathered around my hospital bed in prayer. I remember the 2-hour ambulance ride to St. Jude where they could better care for me. I remember the 2.5 years of weekly chemo treatments, the numerous lumbar punctures and bone marrow aspirates. I remember Doctors Bell, Dahl, and Kalinske, nurses Jean, Judy, and Dale, Miss Chris in social work, Darlene in travel, all part of the team that cared for me. I am a walking memorial to their successes. I remember the other patients I'd see each time I went to the hospital for chemo. I remember when some stopped coming. I knew what that meant. I remember the years of summer camp for children with cancer, children like me. I remember their laughter and the midnight talks of fears and joys, normal kid stuff. Some less so. I remember when some stopped coming. I knew what that meant. But I remember them. I am, and other survivors are, memorials to those who lost their fights.
Expectation is so maddening sometimes. Do you know what she wrote on the eve of Joel's first surgery? The one back in January when we first found the tumor? I seriously feel like a kid on Christmas Eve. I'm pleading for God to spare his life, and I'm tempted to despair because self-inspection leads me to conclude I shouldn't expect much of anything. And yet my wife is expecting a surprise party from the Lord. Replete with presents and supernatural miracles. I envy her.
Joel and the baby night.
Hop in bed, boys. Let's go.
Boys, get in bed.
Oh, can you at least tell us a story?
Sure.
Okay. This is the story of a very brave knight named Joel.
Joel the baby knight?
Yes, Joel the baby knight.
Joel's a knight.
But he's also Joel the very brave knight. And he was being chased by a dragon named Cancer.
Because of his tumor?
Mm-hmm.
Where does the dragon live?
In a forest.
Is the dragon big?
Very big.
Does the dragon breathe fire?
So much fire, you guys.
So, Joel has armor, like a sword and a shield and stuff?
Ooh, or maybe a spear?
Yeah, that sounds good. So brave Sir Joel, with his sword and his shield and his awesome spear and his super jumping ability, was being chased by a dragon named Cancer.
What other superpowers does he have?
He also has legs.
That's not a superpower.
It's the best superpower.
You guys know what grace means?
Yeah, it's kind of like help.
Yeah, it's kind of like help. You know, and he's not the only one who's ever tried to fight this dragon. Some very brave knights have fought this dragon and lost. And some are able to drive the dragon off, and then they can go home and they can quit fighting for a while.
Joel's been fighting this dragon for a long time, huh?
A long time.
And guess what? I'm helping
fight it. But Joel found a nice empty cave where he could rest.
I have not directly on the program still. I'm gonna fix this. Okay, I have something to fix.
And it seems like the dragon couldn't find him. But just when he thought that the danger was past, the dragon found his hiding spot and came after him in the cave.
Come on, Joel. Well,
that dragon's going to kill Joel. Joel's going to lose.
Why do you say that?
Because Joel is just a baby. Babies can't kill dragons.
You're right.
Joel.
Can't kill a dragon. But that's the best part of the story. God fights for Joel. He fights that dragon cancer right with Joel.
Come on, get up.
We know that God can win, even if Joel can't. That's grace.
Tim from church, Mom. He died from cancer. Wasn't God fighting for him? Didn't he have him?
Of course, God fought for Tim, too. Tim fought so well. And he was so brave and so strong that God let him rest. It may have seemed like the dragon won because Tim died. We know that Tim's in heaven and that he's with God and that God is so proud of him. So maybe for Tim getting to be done fighting.
I can't.
You have to. You'll drown.
We're already drowning. How can you sit there like that?
Despair doesn't help anything.
Neither does false hope. And I'm not despairing.
How can you say false hope? You're drowning.
Well, you're missing your oars. And you don't even know where you're going. And yet you're so sure you're gonna get there.
It's better than drowning.
Well, enjoy floating on the surface like you always do.
There's nothing deep about drowning. Just get in the boat.
You have to let me feel this. Someone has to.
That's not fair. I love him as much as you do. I just really believe we're going to be okay. I'm sure my expectation looks like denial, but seeing Joel dying does not make me any less certain that he will be healed. In some ways, I feel more certain, not because the same doubts don't come to me, but because I know that they will not be entertained much longer, because this chapter is almost finished, and we will have an ending one way or the other. So the doubts and fears that make me reaffirm that even if I'm wrong, this is where I stand, become less and less powerful. He
people's conciliatory words of comfort meant to reassure us and help us accept Joel's death don't sit well with me. They aren't offensive because I know the heart behind them is good, but they are weak words because it's so obvious to me that death is the given. I don't have to work to be ready for it or accept it. It is coming whether I would accept it or not. It has been coming slowly for so long. I don't have to work to understand that Joel is dying. It is obvious. Heaven is amazing. And so I'm not worried about death. It will come regardless of where I stand and wait. But now, death is circling close enough for
redemption of my life. There's a guy still down here. Where is he?
The sunset looks pretty from here. The orange glow cast on the wall. Better than the muted colors of this hospital. I wonder why they choose blues and greens. They, the ones who choose the colors that heal. Green for life. Blue. For comfort? Purple stripes to hide the stains. This chair is too small and sticks to my skin. I hate vinyl. Blue, purple. The ocean, maybe? No, under the ocean. Silent, warm, and salty, like tears. He won't stop crying. I don't blame him. He feels miserable. I hate that we're here. I hate that he's sick. I just want him to feel better. I hate this room. I didn't used to. For a moment, it was an adventure. I was cast as the compassionate and caring father, holed up with his fragile son in a small cleft in the rocks. The storm raging, waves ripping at the sharp black rocks below, and enveloped in my arms, he feels safe, and I am holding him firmly. Trying not to slip. Because if you hold tight enough, nothing will take him. Right? It's okay, Jolly. Shh. Oh, don't throw your head, buddy. Don't. Here we go, bouncing around. Do you like
that? Oh, I love your giggle. Bounce around. Is that funny? A bounce, a bounce, a bounce, bounce, bounce. Oh, he won't stop crying. He hits the box. I don't catch it. He drinks it greedily. Big, deep gulps. Okay, Jolie, that's enough. Breathe, kiddo. And he does. And I wipe his face of snot. And tears and juice. And then he vomits, and I catch it. I always catch it. I know you're thirsty, buddy, but you'll throw it up. No, don't grab too hard. You'll squirt all the juice out. Here, let me have it. You. I can't make you feel better. Okay, buddy, okay. I'll hold you. Oh, Joel Bug. You look so miserable. No! Don't hit your head on the bars, Joel. Joel! Joel! I know you're mad. Please stop. Please. Stop.
Come on, man. We've been through so much.
I shake. I weep. I pray. I plead. I need peace. You are. You are there. I want you here. I want you to call my son. And you've brought us this far. He's still here, not dead, not there, with you. God, I want him here with me. Peace. He sleeps. Thank you.
There's a story in the Bible where Jesus and his disciples are on a boat. And a furious storm hits the sea and everyone thinks they're gonna die. Where do you think Jesus is? Rowing alongside them? No. He's asleep in the back of the boat. So his disciples are freaking out and wake him up, and they say, "Don't you care if we drown?" So Jesus gets up and he says to the storm, "Quiet, be still." And the sea becomes completely calm. Then he asks his disciples why they are so scared and if they have any faith at all. Like he was frustrated with them. Because even though Jesus said, "Let's go to the other side of the lake," his disciples thought he was going to just let them die.
About 3.5 hours, bud.
Oh. Well, it's 10 a.m. now, so that means you guys can grab one more item from your road trip bags.
And it's my turn to be the king.
Oh, I love you. It's okay. You were a very good, noble, just, and true king. But now we have to do it, I suppose.
My first edict as king is we dance like egg monkeys for 30 minutes.
Maybe like 5 minutes?
Nope.
He does die, will Jesus even care? Will he weep for him as he did for Lazarus? Will he weep for me? I think greater than my fear of death is that of insignificance. Or rather, my default assumption is that my thoughts and passions and loves and the stuff of my being are insignificant. How could the creator of all that is and ever was love my son as he did Lazarus? And could my soul stranded on this blue raft, awash in a sea of stars, ice, and dust, matter enough to him to turn his hand in mercy? Jesus wept for Lazarus. 5 minutes later, he raised Lazarus from the dead.
I'm sorry. I should have known we'd both end up in the same place. We always do. It just scares me every time. I just really believe he'll be healed. I know you believe too, just when you act like that, I get all unsure.
I don't know that.
What do you mean?
I just hope that. I don't know.
It's sad.
I will not let you go unless you bless him.
Have mercy on us because he is weak. Oh Lord, my God, let this boy's life return to him.
I will not let you go unless you bless him.
Oh Lord, my God, let this boy's life return to him.
Everything you have, we don't want to settle for less than who we know you to be.
Rise up, my God, come save him.
Right now, in the name of Jesus, that you would heal Joel. Father, right now, that we don't accept this is what's great for our
lives. I will not let you go. I will not let you go. I will not let you go.
Really confused right now, guys. Might be a state of the special team. Really sorry, this is not very bad. We might be able to edit this video because this is gonna be so long. How to finish a church scene. He's fading away. He's fading away.
He was not in the wind. He was not in the earthquake. He was not in the fire. He was here.
This is beautiful. That poor family. Pick me from the edge of the world.
So here we are, and the air is emptier without his laugh, and yet our hearts are still full, but with a different drink. And this ride we've been on for so long is silent, and so also the Lord. And so we sit here in this new silence, and long for the music to start again, and for the disc to spin again, even if it means going round and round for many more years. for at least we would be moving and Joel would be laughing here on Earth. And not only in heaven.
You like it over there?
But in this space, I sense his silence is only because he is drawing his breath. And now we know love and longing, empty and full, all in one moment. And I am grateful that we loved him well. And that we miss him well. And I hope that in the Lord's next breath, he will whisper his love song to you, his beloved.
We're over there, buddy.
And that you will know him differently and more deeply. But now, we grieve in silence, yet not without his presence.
Guess we'll always remain in the heart. You're not truly gone if you had the good memories. You're not truly gone if they're still in your heart. If someone leaves, they are always a part of you. I never had it on such an emotional level to the point of a human being, but like, I've lost.
I remember you. You made it too. I'm glad you're here. I love it here. I bet you like it too.
Heaven, isn't it?
Look at all these pancakes. Did you ever see pancakes like this?
Oh,
the big as me. The big ones is for me. A little one is for my dog. I always wanted a dog, and now I got one.
You did?
I even got to name it.
What's his name?
Banjo.
Banjo. Hello, Banjo Kazooie. We can pop bubbles.
Whoa, bubbles?
Oh. Pop, pop, pop. Pop them all. Come on, buddy. I got you. Can you pop them?
Manji doesn't catch a bubble. He likes to bite them.
Come on, Manji.
I love bubbles.
Pop, bubble, 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 pop, bubble, bubble. Oh. I love bubbles too, little buddy. Bubbles are
look,
fun.
Look, I can catch one.
Do it.
I want my bubbles.
You got my bubbles. Wah.
I love my bubbles.
You do. I love them too.
Come here, Manju.
Come
have
on,
another
Manju.
Pancake.
Yeah. Don't you like pancakes?
I can eat wherever I want. I never fall.
I never mind. I'm a bubble-blowing bubble baby. How about you, little buddy? You're like we all are on the inside, aren't we? Where am I going? So, he left. He's in heaven. For playing. Oh my god, that's the end. Wait, no, this cannot be real. Oh my god, that was real. Who's real? I'm Look at him. He's having so much fun. Little buddy. He must love his horses. Hold on to your horses there, buddy. He looks so happy. Oh, look at them puppies. Special things. Look at that kid. Look at his face in the top one. The face of pure evil. Look how adorable he is. Look at him. Oh, look at him. Pirate outfit. Lightning McQueen. Ka-chow. That's how you know if your kid's done something. They got that face. So soon, and it happens every day. People that would grow up to be great, they don't even get to grow up. This game was beautiful. This game is beautiful because it captures it so perfectly. It captures the struggle, it captures the sadness, it captures the anger. It captures the good times and it captures the bad times. It shows everything. So perfectly, too. This is one of my favorite games I've ever played. I recommend getting it, whether you've seen it or not, just get it just to support the guy. Because I bet he needs a lot of support after what he's gone through, because judging by the looks of it, it's a lot. If I had the money, I would support him. I don't. Maybe one of you guys do, but I don't. I'm still 13. This is the first game I've played in 13 years of my life that has made me this sad. guys. I recommend getting this kid. It's beautiful. Alright, I don't want to waste any more of your guys' time. It's been me, Jim, and Coleman. And this has been the Dragon Cancer. Thank you. I hope you have a good day. And stay healthy.